So we have another Democratic Party primary debate taking place in Las Vegas ahead of the Nevada primary on Saturday. And I've got good news and semi-bad news. The good news is that we knocked out one billionaire because Tom Steyer did not qualify for this debate. Hasta la vista, don't care. You should have never been able to buy your way onto that debate stage to begin with. But the bad news is that Mike Bloomberg, because the DNC changed the rules in his favor, has qualified. Now, that's bad because it shows real corruption. I mean, after donating to the DNC, they changed the rules for you. Like, that is inherently disgusting. It should be sickening to everyone. But on another hand, he should have to face the music. He should be challenged for his record. And if the mainstream media isn't going to challenge him, then certainly he needs to at least own up to what he's done as mayor of New York City, his record of donating to Republicans, his racist and sexist remarks from the other candidates. They should be able to challenge him, right? Because up until this point, he's ran this parallel Democratic primary where he just releases these ads and he's been hiding his face. He oftentimes doesn't even appear in these ads. He just has people talking about him. But I mean, we need to know who you are. Voters have a right to know about you if you've bought your way up to second place nationally, essentially. So he has qualified for this debate. Will he actually show up? That is a different question. I don't know. But here's what I will say. When it comes to what we should expect or look for these candidates, if I'm Mike Bloomberg, I have to make a really good first impression because for a lot of people, nationally, this is the first time that they're seeing Mike Bloomberg, the man himself, the man behind the curtain, because they've seen his ads now. You can't watch TV without seeing his ads. So now they're going to see, is he really what he's been leading us to believe? So he's going to have to make a good first impression. And on top of that, he's going to have to be able to withstand attacks from the other candidates that will inevitably come. Because, I mean, if you're going to take on Donald Trump, you've got to prove that you have the ability to fight. So he's going to have to do that and be able to defend himself. You can't deflect and cry about mean Bernie bros exposing your racism and sexism. You are going to have to defend your record. Will he be able to do that? I don't know. Now, when it comes to the other individuals who qualified, we have Joe Biden, Pete Buttigieg, Amy Klobuchar, Bernie Sanders, and Elizabeth Warren. Now, Joe Biden needs a good performance. And when I say a good performance, I want to emphasize a really, really, really good performance. He is hanging on for dear life. Odds are he's going to get crushed in Nevada. And he's clinging to that hope that maybe he can pull out a victory in South Carolina. I think that the odds are in his favor at this point in time. But if Bernie really does perform really well in Nevada, like the polls are showing he will, that could give him enough momentum to carry him to victory in South Carolina, which is bad news for Joe Biden. So he's hanging on and he's got to have a good performance. He should be attacking Pete Buttigieg and Amy Klobuchar primarily, even though Bernie Sanders is the front runner. You have three individuals competing for that centrist lane, and he has to show people why he's the one to take on Bernie Sanders. He has to communicate to voters that he is the anti-Bernie choice if people don't like Bernie Sanders. If I'm Pete Buttigieg, he's got to reassert himself, go after Joe Biden and Amy Klobuchar, and try to position himself as the anti-Bernie candidate. I mean, Amy Klobuchar has now kind of usurped him, at least when it comes to momentum. She came in third place, but because the media was focused more on that than his second place victory in New Hampshire, well, she's kind of stealing that spotlight away from him. So he's got to try to have a good performance and steal it back from her. If I'm Amy Klobuchar, I'm just doing what I say Pete Buttigieg and Joe Biden should do. Try to present yourself as the competent anti-Bernie choice, because you know, you have three moderates essentially splitting the votes, and even if they can't all pull delegates at the convention and try to steal it from Bernie Sanders, I mean, you want to have a really good case for yourself. You want a strong plurality, and she's got to make this case for herself. She's not doing well with voters of color, so she needs to at least recognize, you know, the issues that face the Latino community, black and brown people, and she hasn't been doing well with them. So going into Nevada, she has to prove herself, and she can assert that she's actually cognizant of the issues that these communities of color face at this debate. Will she do it? Probably not. I'm sure that she's going to say the same thing that she said throughout the past, you know, eight debates, and the media will once again declare her as the winner because they love her all of a sudden. When it comes to Elizabeth Warren, I don't know what to say about Elizabeth Warren. She could come in a distant second, according to polls in Nevada, but if I'm Elizabeth Warren, here's what I'm doing. I am teaming up with Bernie Sanders strategically in this debate. Now, she's been going in the opposite direction, attacking Bernie, attacking his supporters, but she did the best at these debates when her and Bernie worked together. If they formed this alliance at this debate, and if she actually defended Bernie Sanders when the attacks inevitably are lobbed at him by the moderates, then she can get a lot of momentum. People can really, you know, maybe rekindle the flame. I don't think that's really possible, but at least not dislike her as much because of her recent, divisiveness, if you will, as she preaches unity. So if she were able to kind of like ride on Bernie's coattails and try to defend him and be his wingman or wingwoman during this debate, I think that can help her and maybe, you know, reignite talks of this Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren ticket. Will she do that? Probably not. She's most likely going to take a backseat during the healthcare portion of this debate that will inevitably come up, not mention Medicare for All, and just come up with these vague, you know, platitudes about selfies and whatnot. I'm not expecting much, but she needs a good performance, and I can't see any other way that she can actually shine unless she really tries to reinvigorate the left. And it's a long shot, but it's your only hope right now. When it comes to Bernie Sanders, he needs a solid performance. But if I'm him, I'm probably not going to be super aggressive. But if somebody does, you know, attack me, I'm definitely counterpunching if I'm Bernie Sanders. I'm going to be able to show that I can absorb blows and counterpunch, you know, give people a taste of their own medicine. And I'm certainly going after Bloomberg if he says anything about me. If he says anything about toxic Bernie bros, I am talking about his toxic behavior, his treatment of people who worked for him, the women, 64 individuals who claim that, you know, they were sexually harassed by Mike Bloomberg. That's what I would do if I'm Bernie Sanders. But overall, this debate, I mean, no matter what happens, I think that the outcome is already predetermined by the mainstream media. Bernie Sanders will not win according to their standards. Maybe Mike Bloomberg will win because they don't want to say that he lost. Maybe Amy Klobuchar or Pete Buttigieg pull it off. Maybe Joe Biden has a comeback. But we don't know what's going to happen. All I know is that what's most important is what voters think when watching this. The non-politically savvy, just casual observers. What they see as strength is what's going to matter the most. And we won't really know until people vote on Saturday at the Nevada caucus. But this will be interesting. Maybe Mike Bloomberg will show up. Maybe he won't. If he doesn't, he's certainly a coward because the DNC already changed the rules at his behest. So you might as well show up and face the music. You've got to at some point. You can't hide your face forever. Will he do it? I don't know, but this will be certainly interesting if he is there, and I would advise you to bring your popcorn. So look out for my post-debate analysis the day after the debate airs.